In this video from ITFreeTraining, I will look at how to install and use remote management tools for Windows 7. After this, I will show you how to use Microsoft Management Console to administer your servers both locally and from remote. Using both of these makes it a lot easier for an administrator to perform maintenance on the network. When supporting Windows servers, you are not likely to be using a server product as your workstation. Most likely, it will be a Windows client like Windows 7. Client operating systems, such as Windows 7, do not come with the administration tools that are found in Windows Server, so these will have to be downloaded and installed. The tools are provided in the Remote Server Administration Tools, otherwise known as RSAT. RSAT is available as a free download from the Microsoft website. In order to use these tools, you need to be running Windows Vista or above. RSAT is very operating system specific, so you will need to download the correct version for your operating system. For example, you could not install the Windows 7 download on your Windows Vista computer. You will also need to ensure that you have the required service pack installed, depending on which version of RSAT that was downloaded. If you are running Windows XP, you can use the Administration Tools pack. This was the predecessor to RSAT, so does not have all the same features. It is also known as the Admin pack. Although the Admin pack does not have all the same features, if you need to use Windows XP to perform administration, it is better than nothing. Once you have the tools installed, Microsoft provides a way to group these tools together in the one interface. This was introduced in Windows Server 2000 when Microsoft created the Microsoft Management Console, or MMC. MMC provides a standardized framework for administration tools. The MMC allows multiple tools to be grouped together, or they can be run standalone. Each time you run an admin tool, like Active Directory Users and Computers, you are in fact running the MMC with that tool only. Since multiple tools can be added to the one MMC interface, these are often referred to as snap-ins. The advantage of the MMC is that once you have customized it to your specifications, you can then save it for later. I will now change to my Windows 7 computer to look at how to install the remote server administration tools and how to use MMC. In order to have the additional administration tools available in Windows 7, I will first download the Remote Server Administration Tools. There are a number of different downloads depending on which operating system you are running. I find the easiest way to find the download is to open Internet Explorer and simply search for RSAT, or Remote Server Administration Tools. Once you have found the appropriate website, ensure that you are downloading the correct version for that operating system and also check that you have downloaded the appropriate 32-bit or 64-bit version for your operating system. In this case, I have already downloaded the installer, so I will now close Internet Explorer and run the installer from the desktop. The installer only requires that you accept the license agreement when asked. The install process on this computer takes about 10 minutes to complete, so I will pause the video and return when the install is complete. With installation complete, a help document will now appear explaining what to do next. In order to start using the administrative tools, I will now decide which tools will be available for this operating system. To do this, I will now open the control panel and select the options Programs. Once the Programs opens, I will select the option Programs and Features. The administration tools are installed as features. To enable them, select the option on the left, Turn Windows Features On or Off. The feature that needs to be enabled is Remote Server Administration Tools. Notice, however, when selected, there is no tick in the box. Instead, there is a square. If I expand Remote Server Administration Tools, notice that none of the options are ticked. In order to start using the administration tools, you need to individually select which ones you want. For server administration, you will want to ensure Server Manager is selected. Under Role Administration Tools, you next need to select which roles on your servers you want to administer from this workstation. You could go on and select them all, but once again, you will need to expand the options to ensure the options you want are selected. Some options appear under Feature Administration Tools. One important option to select is Group Policy Management Tools. This will install the group policy management tools that a lot of administrators use when administering an Active Directory domain. In later videos, I will be looking a lot at group policy. Once I press OK, the tools that I just selected will be installed. The process takes a few minutes. Installation time will be dependent on how many tools were selected. I will now pause the video and return once installation is complete. Once the install is complete, notice that under Administrative Tools, Active Directory Users and Computers, and a number of other tools are available that were not available before. Since these tools have been installed, they are now available to the MMC in the form of a snap-in. To use them, first of all, I will open MMC from the Start menu. To add a snap-in, select File, and then select Add Remove Snap-in. In this case, I will add Active Directory Users and Computers and a second snap-in for Remote Desktop. Notice that when the snap-in has been added, the Active Directory Users and Computers snap-in works the same as if Active Directory Users and Computers had been run by itself. I can now navigate down through the OUs and perform administration the same as if I had connected to a domain controller and run Active Directory Users and Computers from there. If I now right-click on Remote Desktop and select the option Add New Connection, I can enter in the computer that I want to create a remote desktop connection to. In this case, I will enter the server name NYDC1. I can now use the same procedure to add NYDC2. To establish a remote connection to NYDC1, all I need to do now is double-click on the connection. With remote connection, some administrative functions will be disabled by default. To enable it, in Server Manager, select the option Configure Server Manager Remote Management. Once selected, all that needs to be enabled is Enable Remote Management for this server from other computers. Now that the setting is enabled, I will be able to add the snap-in Server Manager from the File menu. When the snap-in is added, I will be prompted for the server name, which will be NYDC1. If I had attempted to enter in NYDC1 without the server being configured for remote management, this step would have failed. Once the snap-in is added, I can now expand through Server Manager the same way Server Manager would operate if I were in front of the server. You can start to see how MMC can be used to group together your most commonly used admin tools in the one place. You can potentially add all servers in your company into the same MMC and switch between them very easily. Once the MMC console has been set up, you can now save it from the File menu. In this case, I will save it to the desktop, so if I want to use it again, I simply need to double-click the icon on the desktop to open it. I am now free to keep making changes to the MMC console. However, in some cases, you may want to prevent changes from being made. For example, you may configure an MMC for help desk support to use, in which, once set up, you do not want them to make changes. If I select File and then select Options, notice that the console mode is set to Author Mode. This will allow changes to be made. The next option down, User Mode Full Access, prevents changes to the MMC console. The user is still free to use any snap-in that was added by the creator of the MMC, but cannot add or remove snap-ins or change the properties of the snap-ins. The next option, User Mode Limited Access Multiple Window, allows the user to open multiple windows in the same MMC console. For example, you could create a new window that only has the one snap-in in it. To switch windows, you can use the menu pull-down and select which windows you want. The last option, User Mode Limited Access Single Window, prevents the user from creating new windows. Since no new windows can be created, the Windows menu is hidden. This concludes our video on how to use MMC on Windows 7 and using remote server administration tools. Using these effectively will allow you to perform administration of your computer's network from your workstation. For more free videos for this course and others, please feel free to subscribe or visit our website. Thanks for watching.